Here's why I did that, because I'm going to do stuff tonight that nobody's way I can just do that and that's the way it goes. Yeah. So where's Bob? Bob.
Right here.
We have a solo performance. Thank you. Just look up Arnie Cheatham and Bob Tovia. He's called Deep. So, what a blessing to know Arnie. Really. And the photography is extraordinary. It's really, some of it really draws me right in. I know it would give Arnie great pleasure to know that we are all here enjoying his artwork and paying honor to his life.
It was just an improv.
Birds, which they sell.
The other great part of this game this evening is that I get to put together ensembles that I think are managed. So say, great, Bill.
Great, everybody.
Y'all didn't mean that. That's okay. These fine gentlemen, notice Arnie's work. What do you see? What do you see besides beauty? What images do you see? Birds. What do birds do? Don't say shit on me. What do birds do?
They make sound and they contribute beauty without asking for any recompense. They make beautiful sounds and they contribute to the beauty of our world. And as a result, our audience who made music with an instrument uses this instrument of a camera to record the beauty of birds. It does not require much talent to press a button. It requires a great deal of talent to know when to press a button and how to frame a picture.
Yeah, but what do birds do? This exhibit is called Fly Away Home. In the black musical tradition, flying away home is part of birds' ability to share beauty with the world. And there are many songs that have to do with people and birds flying. One of the most famous is one called Bye Bye Blackbird. Bye Bye Blackbird. Choose a tempo.
Thank you.
Jerry Sabatino. A young friend, Mr. Alvin Terry. Now, as I mentioned earlier, for some of you who are, you know, you just follow the jazz crowd, you don't know about this kind of stuff. When you see art up on the wall, people have worked weeks and weeks, months and months, putting these, not just up, but up in a particular way. It's an art show. And there is an expectation that some of this art might get sold. Some of it might get sold. Now, I've been informed by Lady Dottie. Say hello to Lady Dottie. Lady Dottie. Because of the nature of the event and who's here, and the fact that most of the people in this room are poor ass musicians, that the.
You mean financial?
Of course.
Economic.
Some of us got money.
Some of us are old, too. That's how that worked. There's a discount. There's a discount from the ordinary price. And if you go to the back, there's a table with a list of pieces. And you can find out how much it would cost you to have like three or four of these pieces up in your space. Arnie and I have a lot of good stuff going on in terms of the two of us. And one of them was that I used to say to Arnie, okay, you play too damn pretty. I would say that, and he wouldn't pay me any money. He would just go on and play pretty all the time anyway. And he said to me once or twice that he was interested, he didn't say it was beautiful, but he said he was interested in the way that I played tuba, because he never heard tuba played quite like that. So just to give you a sense of what this guy who played too pretty may have meant, a good buddy of mine from the Aardvark Jazz Orchestra, where Arnie and I also perform together. We have a little thing that we do, Peter and I. Peter plays beautiful flute, and even more beautiful piccolo, and I have been known to pick up the tuba. And sometimes we improvise.
This is what you want.
That's exactly right. Well, that's not all of it.
Well, size may matter, but not always. It ain't how much you got, it's what you get. Not to me.
Thank you.
So while we're waiting, how many people have purchased 2 photographs already?
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, those of you who are waiting to purchase art, please let it be known that 5 pieces have been sold already. The solo instrumentalist is never solo. The solo instrumentalist generally is working with a whole history of music, a whole history of performance. So we're going to invite Mr. Pablo Carey, I think. Pablo? Yeah? A renegade. From James Gabriel and the Union Band Orchestra, who fortunately have been living in Boston for the last, how long? Five or six years. With the lovely Mary D.C., there she is back there. All right. Pablo's just a great player. And he asked if he could do a solo rendition of one of Arnie's favorite tunes, and one of my favorite tunes, and one of Duke Ellington's favorite tunes. Now that's a combination. I'm still talking because I should have called Pablo up earlier, so we all said, but that's my fault, I'm sorry.
So Dorothy, where are you? Dorothea, where are you at? Dorothea, somebody ask her just to pay attention for just a sec. Dorothea, I just wanted to say how much respect I had personally for Arnie. You know, he made me think of Louis Armstrong getting out the sick bed to come and play. And he would, you know, literally get out the sick bed and come and play. And I know how hard that is because I'm getting out the sick bed and come and play now myself. So I used to call him up and tell him how much I respected him for the fact that no matter what, he was willing to get up there and give his all up until the very end. So I just wanted to tell you that I really respected him deeply.
Thank you.
See, when you're Arnie and Dottie, that's the kind of neighbors you have. That's the kind of neighbors you have. So where's Harry? There's Harry. Come on up. Come on up. Harry's at the drums. Ron Mount D is back at the bass. John Cordoleski is at the piano. And Tim Medaya has agreed to share with us a version of John Coltrane's Naima. Naima. John Coltrane was a genius. No, he really was. In fact, he was a genius who was smart enough to name a song after my daughter 35 years before she was born. That's genius.
Thank you.
Yeah, Tim and I was another one of those who doesn't pay no money. I keep telling him, don't play pretty, and he just ignores me all the time. First of all, I'd like to thank Donnie for making all this happen. I'd like to thank all of you for being here, but before you do anything, please give yourselves a big round of applause. And finally, I'd like to thank Arnie Cheatham for being. This man is holding up his hands. Either he doesn't want to get shot. I mean, he is a black man. So he doesn't want to get shot. Or he's letting me know that there are 10 photographs that have been sold. Thank you. Thank you all. This musical tribute, we should do this again, right? First, we should do this again, right? We should probably do this maybe annually. What do you think? What do you think? Alvin, what do you think?
I think
what you said. What I said? Alvin Terry agreed with what I said. Oh, I see. Good friend. Can I a big hand? We have a grand finale. Now, there were some other things we were going to do, so you have to wait until next year. Come on up here, you can't put it. You got to play on this, brother. I'm sorry. So sorry. Pick out that big horn this time. Yeah, pick out the big horn. I'm going to leave that little one at home. Pick out the big horn. We're going to do some things with the brass that was going to be real interesting, so you have to wait until next time to see that. We were going to let Yoran play a 45-minute solo. But he does that all the time anyway, so it doesn't matter. Just come to any time Yoran is performing and you'll see a 45-minute solo. It'll be good now. Come on, let's be real. It'll be great. But it'll be 45 minutes. But Yoran, how can I ask Yoran to play on this one? I need all the horn players up here, every one of them, every one of these horn players, I need them up here. Every one of them. Trumpet players, saxophone players, kazoo players, flute players. Arnie Cheatham wrote a lot of good music, and one of my favorites is this stomping ass, well, it's not really a blues, but it's kind of a blues. It's a bluesy piece. Called, what's the actual title? Blueberry Blues. Now I have to explain it to some of the people, so ignore this while we're here. Thank you.
Thank you.